Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, you'll start learning all about the storyboard within the effects environment. The storyboard provides you with lots of visual feedback, as well as a fast way of moving between your shots without constantly switching back to your timeline. So whether you're creating VFX or grading, you can see the context of the shots in the sequence, as well as bounce between them with a single click. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Now, to understand what you'll see and where you'll first land up in the effects environment, I'd like to point out that we have a timeline with two video tracks. The focus point is on the top track, which is considered your primary view. This is indicated by the P symbol in the track panel. This is pretty normal, as most of the time you'll want to see all the tracks combined together. We already have some titles and a few basic effects. Now let's say you wanted to apply some effects or grading to this shot. So you'll select it and click the Effects tab. For those of you who prefer to use the keyboard shortcut, press space F4. Now you can start grading straight away with the master grade, or apply any other VFX or look development tools. But in the middle of the interface, you will see the storyboard reel. This is your edited sequence displayed as thumbnails, and the centralized thumbnail with the yellow highlight is your selected clip. Now, what is very important about the storyboard reel is that it has a couple of different sorting modes, and the first one is called track mode. You'll look at the version and sources sorting modes in a later video. The track mode displays one timeline track at a time. That track is based on your selected segment, which in our case is video track 1. You could obviously see this by switching back to the timeline view. But next to the storyboard mode, you can see the current video track, and you could toggle to another video track using the pull-down menu, or press the page up or page down keyboard shortcuts. Now, as a side note, if you had not selected anything before entering the effects environment, the storyboard automatically sets to the primary video track, and whatever segment was under the positioner would become the selected clip. There is nothing wrong with working that way, but by explicitly selecting your clips, you'll know exactly what segment you'll be getting and what track will be focused when switching to the effects environment. Now, the storyboard is currently showing regular segments in the sequence, but you will get indications if a segment is hidden or if the segment is a gap segment. All these options will be represented in the storyboard in order to display the structure of the focused video track. Now, to move around using the storyboard, it's quite straightforward. You can use the player controls, but you can also do it gesturally. So if you have quite a few segments on the track, you can either drag the reel to locate the shots you want, or press Ctrl Home to go to the beginning of the storyboard reel, or press Ctrl End to go to the end of the storyboard reel. As soon as you select a shot, the shot centers itself in the storyboard reel, and all the effects will now be applied to the new shot. So you can easily go from one shot to the next and apply any finishing tasks. You can also navigate the storyboard reel using the previous and next transition buttons, or press the up and down arrow keyboard shortcuts. Now, each thumbnail in the storyboard provides you with a wealth of information particular to that segment. You get each segment's name, and you also see any timeline effects applied to the segment. You can configure this display through the Options pull-down menu. Just choose Storyboard Display, and you can choose what you see and how the information should be displayed in the storyboard. If you need more information than what is displayed in the storyboard, you can alt-click on the shots to display the clip information. Now, I just want to point out that even though the timeline effects are displayed in the storyboard thumbnails, the current selected segment also displays its timeline effects in the effects pipeline beneath the storyboard reel. The info in the storyboard is purely for informational purposes, whereas the effects pipeline is used for practical operations such as switching timeline effects, copy, paste, drag and drop, bypass, delete, etc. Finally, you can scrub thumbnails in the storyboard. This is very useful if you want to quickly skim each segment for a specific frame. You can also use the contextual menu to set the frame as a permanent thumbnail if you want to keep the visual reference. Now you can scrub all the thumbnails in the storyboard except for the current selection. The simple reason is that you just use the time bar to do the same thing, and the thumbnails updates with any operations you perform with the controls. So just from what you have seen in this video, you're getting a lot of visual information and functionality from the storyboard. But there are quite a few more workflow tools using the storyboard to make the workflow even better, and that will be covered in the upcoming videos. But one area to cover before this video finishes is at the beginning, I mentioned that it is normal to see all the video tracks combined to see the full context of the edit. For example, navigating to the first shot, I know this shot has a title on the second track, and we'd like to see it in context with the current selection. So at the moment, the storyboard, using track mode, is set only to focus on video track 1. The viewer, which displays the current result, only shows the result of the current timeline effects on video track 1. But you click the View pull-down menu, you can choose Context and choose Primary Track. You could also toggle 4 on your keyboard. So when navigating the storyboard on any track, or adding any VFX or grading using the Primary Track viewer, you are always seeing the combined result of all your video tracks on the current shot. This includes all the timeline effects applied to the segments. So you can work in context, or you can isolate the segments on their respective tracks by looking at the result view with F4. It's the best of both worlds. Now up to this point, you've only been working within a specific segment range. In other words, you can navigate the storyboard reel, but you can only scrub the range of the single selected segment using the time bar. But in the next video, I'll show you how to extend this to the timeline range to help navigate your sequence even faster within the effects environment. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.